It's Melvin Yong.
Mr. Speaker, the government has been actively diversifying our food supply sources. Most of our top vegetable and seafood imports are well diversified, with over 10 source countries, which include China, Vietnam, Indonesia, Australia, various European countries, United States, United Kingdom, Canada, and even Ecuador. This has helped to strengthen the resilience of our seafood and vegetable supplies. Nonetheless, prices of popular food items tend to rise ahead of festive period because of a surge in demand. Retailers and importers would try to mitigate this by planning ahead and securing more supplies from multiple sources. Apart from the diversification of food import sources, the government continues to work with the Consumer Association of Singapore, CASE, to promote consumer awareness and help consumers make informed purchasing decisions.
Ms. Melvin Yong.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I have two supplementary questions, and I thank MOS for her reply earlier. Singapore is a small city-state with very limited resources. Only 1% of our land is available for food production, and over 90% of our food is imported. From a world that is increasingly being disrupted by both climate change and also supply chain issues, can the MOS share with us what are the factors that play a part in influencing food prices today, and how is MTI helping to keep the prices of our food stable in spite of all these challenges?
Mr. Speaker, sir, I want to thank the member, Mr. Melvin Yong, for his two supplementary questions, and I want to assure him and everyone in the House that MTI, the government, and the various government agencies will spare no effort in our multi-pronged strategy to keep our food supplies and food prices stable. Now, he has two supplementary questions, and on the first one, he asks about what are the factors that contribute and influence the cost of food? And there are many. There are a combination of factors, and this include imported prices, animal feed, energy costs, freight costs, labor costs, seasonal weather patterns, and possible supply chain disruptions. Now, I want to share with Mr. Melvin Yong that the regional weather disruptions that are currently putting upside pressure on Singapore's imported food prices should fade as the monsoon season passes. Now, the general appreciation of Sing dollar against the currencies of many of our key import source countries will also continue to temper cost pressures. Then to Mr. Melvin Yong's second supplementary question, as a small and open economy that imports most of our food supply, Singapore is indeed impacted by trade and possible supply chain disruptions. And the government has in place a multi-pronged strategy involving import diversification, local production, 30 by 30, and also stockpiling to reduce the impact of unforeseen disruptions to our food supply. And this also serves to lower our vulnerability to larger price fluctuations and ensure that the prices remain competitive. This strategy is important because to some extent, it will help to act as an important hedge to mitigate the risk of price and also supply disruptions. Now, I want to assure Mr. Melvin Yong that to ensure the continuity of our food supply, MTI has been working very closely with our local companies, especially in the past few years, to ensure sufficient supply of essential food items. Today, we import our food from 170 countries from all over the world. And I also want to add that our multi-level mitigation efforts include bringing in the stocks ahead of time where possible, by working closely with our importers, distributors, and even our retailers to anticipate and even mitigate delays, as well as closely monitoring and looking out for potential disruptors. Now, I was very heartened. I'm sure all of us are very heartened to learn about the efforts by our retailers, such as the Fair Price Group. They are, and some of our supermarkets, they are making concerted efforts to moderate prices despite the cost pressures and disrupted supply chain. Just yesterday, we read that the Fair Price supermarket announced their Stretch Your Dollar campaign, which will give consumers and customers a weekly additional 5% discount on basic food items every Friday, I believe starting on the 4th of March. And besides existing discount schemes for the Pioneer and Merdeka generations and Blue Trust card holders, Fair Price is lowering or holding the prices of popular breakfast items stable in their Kopitiam and food fair chains. And this morning, as I read the Lianhe Zaobao, I was also very heartened to read that not just Fair Price, but other supermarkets like Giant, Sheng Siong, Prime, and also Hao Supermarket also come out with very creative ways to keep the prices consumer-friendly. So I want to assure Mr. Melvin Yong and everyone in the House that MTI and the government and relevant agencies like the SFA and also MSE, we will spare no efforts in our multi-pronged approach to keep our food supply and our food price stable.